Abbey Road. I don't know if you all know, but I'm a love junkie. You see, you know how some people can have a drink with dinner and not wind up in a ditch? You know, some people can do cocaine at a party and not wind up dead. Well, some people can fall in love and not end up in a mental institution, you know? But not me, you know. Well, I could drink a case of him, and I'm not on my feet, no. I'm so drunk in love. And the truth is, it really is like, dear stranger, I love you. Because I get so caught up in fantasy that I don't really even know who they are individually at all. And I'm like, hey, what's your name? No, really, what's your name?
Yes.
What's your last name?
De Silva.
Bridget De Silva. I like the way that sounds. I mean, I know you're here on a dater, but you know, hey, I like unavailable men. Can you hold this for me? Take care of that heart, okay? But the truth is, I don't want just one person to love me. I want everyone to love me. Including their friends and their sisters and their brothers and their cousins and their grandmothers and their hairdressers, clients, nephews, drug dealer. Like right now, I want you all to love me. So why don't you take out your phones? This is the appropriate moment. And take a picture of me and post it to Instagram to let them all know. Hashtag Bridget Barkin. Hashtag Dear Stranger, I love you. Hashtag she's amazing. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna give you some poses. Ready? Go. Oh my god, I gotta tell you about the shoe. He's here, Chris. Chris sold me these shoes. I'll tell you about it. He's my one of his dear stranger. Oh my god, it's amazing. The universe totally like brought these shoes to me. And he helped me buy them. Thanks. So, okay. So what should I do now? Because I want to make you all so very happy. That is all I care about. So, what should I sing about? Give me a, oh, rock and roll. Should we do a rock and roll song? Okay, but can someone give me a word? Because we're gonna make that shit up right now.
Epiphany.
What?
Snake epiphany, oh God. Are you starving yourself? You know, a lot of people say that heroin addicts, all addicts, end up going to Love Junkie meetings because that's where it all begins. So, one day, I was in Union Square and I was looking at all the bag ladies and the crazies and the forgottens and the junkies, you know? I was like, maybe we have something in common, you know? She shacking up with this new dude, a total space basehead, man. And I went there to go grab my, like, 32-inch TV, you know? And I go there, and this guy has the nerve to tell me that I'm stealing his TV. I'm like, man, I found that TV on 82nd Street and 3rd Avenue. I carried that TV on my back 4 flights of stairs. Did you carry that TV on 4 flights of stairs? I don't think so. And then he maced me in my heart. I don't do anything to nobody, you know? What the fuck is that? What a douchebag. But I didn't do anything, you know? I didn't do anything, you know, because I believe in karma. And I don't get his. And I don't want to be with that shrink anyway. I mean, just being with her is karma. That should be her name. Karma. Because she shits over all of her bedding. Nice to meet you, karma! You know, I grabbed the rest of my shit, you know. Like these curtains. Aren't these nice curtains? You know, you can hang them up in your bedroom, make you feel like you're on vacation. Oh, my eye, man. Shit. I'm alright, though, you know. I'm seeing everything real clearly, even though I'm half blind, you know. Because I don't believe in problems, you know. I believe in situations. You know, everybody's got problems, but situations, you know, you can, like, just see them with the bird's eye view, you know. You see that cross right there? That's the cross of victory. Because with God, I am victorious. Yeah, I'm not Christian or anything like that. I'm just spiritual. And I just believe in a lot of, you know, meditation. I'm connected to my chi, you know? You see the scar right here? You see the scar right there? You see that? I got hit by a train last year. We were, you know, racing tracks, whatever. And I didn't even feel a thing, though, you know? I didn't feel a fucking thing, because I was hot, you know? I was hot, you know? I used to be a heroin addict, yeah. But, you know, heroin ruined my life, you know? So, you know, and I get my dose of methadone, you know? I'm cool, you know? And I'm going to school, I'm going to be a child psychologist, because, you know, if I can stop one kid from getting his first high, then I feel like I did my job on the planet, you know? Because that's where it started for me, you know, it was just the first hit, and I wanted more and better and more and higher, so I was so high, I was low, I was on the down looking up at the down, you know? Shit, man, my eye, sorry to bother you, man, you know, I'm your old Ringekyo, motherfucker, you think maybe you want to buy these curtains?
Thank you.
dancing back and forth between things and microphones and, you know, I can't just make it simple. I gotta make it hard. I gotta make it real hard. So, I've had a hungry ghost inside of me for as long as I can remember. I've always been in love with love, and this here is my diary from childhood. And I pull up that image. And let that boy fall in love with me, too, please. I want to get Frenched badly. God, oh God, please, God, oh please, and felt up.
I don't remember. I'm deeply loved now.
I mean, I'm one of those people that just loves life. I love everyone. Like, I don't know, I'm just a loving person.
I believe that love, I felt that, you know.
Because I think often we think we're in love, but we're not, because it's all hard to say one thing and our head is saying the other thing. When you're in love, your heart is just full and you are happy and energized and yeah.
And you're not in pain.
And you're not in pain. And it comes free, it comes without effort.
So, you know, kissing is a gateway drug. Once you get in the love, right, you're like, what the fuck? What is it gonna make me become, you know? So, I was on the J train platform going down to Brooklyn, and I saw a guy standing on one side of where I was, calling out across the platform. Yeah, you're right. Working it out. He was calling out to his daughter. Denim, go get mommy. Yo, Tiffany, I love you so much, yo. Yo, I cross these tracks for you right now, but move back, Josiah. Stop playing. The train is coming. Tiffany. children caught in between it all. Patterns of my childhood, have I carried them over into my life now? Power struggle, this constant push and pull, uptown, downtown trains, delays, track service, out of service, out of service, I'm out of service.
No, I want that back, sorry. No.
Yeah. myself, you know, and I'm like, hey, you know, I know I deserve more than this, but somehow there's like this weird pattern in my head that I act out that I don't deserve more. And, you know, I would hear it and it would be in there muddled in all the voices. And my mom always told me to listen to the God voice within, right? But I can't always hear her inside all the chatter, you know?
Now,
one day, when I was on the bus going from Williamsburg to Bed-Stuy, I overheard two women talking. And it kind of felt like it was God speaking to me. Unless you consider marrying my uncle, Mark. In that case, she worked. That's the real work, boo. I mean, I'm not materialistic or anything like that. It's just that those Chinatown knockoffs just fall apart and you have to go buy another one anyway. Well, this one's strong, built to last. And I know how much it's worth. I understand. And I imagined that this heavenly glow would appear behind them and they would look straight at me and say, what are you gonna do? Return yourself in your broke? You can't, unless you're returning yourself to eternity, to the infinite, constant, universal, massive love. And until then, you gotta take care of yourself. That's right, boo. You gotta keep the receipt in the bag. Know your worth. Know your worth. Know your worth. Know your worth. So I see me claiming my worth now is my own act of revolution. It's micro to the macro, macro to the micro. Because sticking up for myself and breaking the cycle of codependency is bigger than me. How many times women are told to take it lying down? Not anymore. Oh no. It is micro to the macro, and I am building a fortress around me. That is right, I am building the house of sheep.
Yeah.
you know, I focused on my art, you know. Do your work, and then they'll be lining up around the block and it won't be for the new Nikes! It'll be for you! That's what my dad said. Do your work. So I've been doing the work, you know, I started auditioning again. I don't know if you know, I was a child actress. Cute video! That's me as baby Jesus! Oh, and little Dorothy.
Are you still guarding secrets? Why the Cornelius?
Yep, rightfully as well from the whole colonel, you know.
Everybody does that. That's why their comrade tastes so corny.
But it's still my secret.
You know, it really is a good secret. Even if everybody does know it.
So I was on Sesame Street, you know, I did this whole thing. I've been doing this a long, long time, like, as a performer, right? So, you know, you'd think I'd go to these auditions and I would be confident, like, oh, you know, hey guys, it's just me, I'm like 75 and, you know, in this industry, basically, you know? But I still get really nervous, it's true. So I went to an audition, oh, they're still going? Oh, I'm throwing up. Oh, that was cum. I spit out cum and I sank in that. And there I am as the one-legged hooker, yay! Right before the booty pop. Okay, so I went to this audition. I went to an open call for Janis Joplin. I was like, oh, I got this. And I walk in, like, you know, hundreds of girls in boas and, you know, that whole thing. And in walks this woman who is like 50 years old in a fishnet pink jumpsuit with like a purple bra, silver hair out to here, and a cane. What's that? Oh, someone's calling. I should probably put it on vibrate, you know? I don't like that thing. This haunted now, which is. What's that you got over there? I got a picture? Oh shit. I didn't bring a picture. Oh. What's that, sheet music? What do you mean sheet music? I can't write a single fucking blues. The piano player can't play an A-flat blues and he's a fucking idiot. I'll sing that shit on the blues. And I heard that there's like a comic with Corey on. I don't get it. What's Janis Joplin gonna do with Corey on? She's gonna throw my head on? A couple of kicks, act drunk. I mean, I can do it, you know. I don't really need this cane, it's just so I can get a seat on the subway. You know, I used to sing in all the clubs in Harlem, you know. They never believed the voice that came out of me. I didn't really believe it either. I wasn't so confident when I was your age. What a waste. Well, let me tell you something. Your mind is like an airport. Not all thoughts are your own. Okay? Thank you, Michelle Guido. That's the motherfucking show! Microphone!
And I hold you in my head.
fucking my art. I'm making love to my art. I'm focused. I'm committed to my art. You know, it doesn't mean that I have to necessarily be committed to anything or anyone else, right? Free love, as my best friend Hot Sauce likes to tell me. I don't know if you know about her, but she lives in San Francisco with her boyfriend, Dancing Johnny Buffalo, and his wife. And she told me, you know, Bridget, you need to stand in the center of your universe. You can't own someone's stratosphere. You can only rent a space inside of their ozone. We're all like little planets, right, guys? We're all like little planets. We're all planets, just like circling, just like circling around each other, you know? We're all just like little planets, you know? Just like little planets circling around each other, you know? You can go that way. That circling. Sorry. I'll make sure you're ready. Whenever you're ready, let me know. You ready? Almost. Oh, guys, Del Mar Key, Ron Thomas, Bradley, Red Eye, Xavier Smith. Oh, my God. How did you get here? It's like different shoes for different occasions. Like Hot Sauce says, multiple lives, multiple men. Right? Ready? Oh, okay.
Let's come together. You
Don't you want to go to breakfast or something? Where's your show on the 11th? Oh, I'll make sure I let everybody know that. Okay, thanks. Bye, guys.
Oh, I'm holding to the sky.
walking by the water, and I met this guy, and he was looking, you know, he was lost and he needed directions. And,
I'm gonna adjust some things here. And,
he came to one of my shows. He was the stranger of the day. And, he asked me if I would do an exchange with him where he would give me a private yoga class and I could sing songs for him. So we went to Prospect Park.
And,
I brought my guitar. Drink a little water because that chocolate is really getting to me now. So, and he told me that I needed to come to a place of forgiveness. And so I knew that, and I knew I needed to forgive him. And then he said that I couldn't really get love, the love I wanted from this man because he was a beggar, and I was a beggar. And we were both begging from each other, so we really couldn't come away with anything. And I originally wrote that song right there in that moment with him when he said that to me. I'm so inspired. But now it means a little something different because it's not like I need to forgive them, but I need to forgive me because I haven't always been forgiving myself, you know? So this is really a song to myself. They say time heals, but who are they anyway? Are they angels? Are they kings telling us to deal with what we're given? They say time heals, but what is time anyway? A year in the blink of an eye, an hour feels like a day. Are you ready? Yes, I'm ready. Wings so heavy, life fragmented, wise man plenty. Two beggars begging, I remember. Don't forget. It's been long enough for me now to move on. Standing tall, the pillars are strong, holding the roof over my head. They say love will find you, but you've got to find it first. Dig down deep in the caverns, I found it right where it hurts. Are you ready? Yes, I'm ready. Wings so heavy, life fragmenting, wise man plenty, two beggars begging. Don't forget me. play that next video.
What is, like, something that you go to for stress? How long have you guys been together?
6 years.
6 years. And what about your life in
the future? It's amazing. Like, the sanity in my answer.
So what would you say is the thing that makes you strong after a heartbreak?
Friends. After friends. Real good friends. That's when you actually find out who your true friends are. So that's time, right? When you have to heal.
That wasn't love. What do you think love is?
But something that can help complete you as a person when you're around, you know?
So if they complete you and you break up, you lose a part of yourself.
I feel like not having that may even help you be aware of what you're missing, you know, now that they're gone.
When they leave, they leave the space that then you are aware of and there is
exactly.
Space.
Because they filled it.
So then, what do you do then? When
that's,
you're aware of the space.
That's a concern of her.
So something that I started to do to grow is I went on pilgrimage to Ireland by myself, and I found myself in Doolin, and I was really there, like, you know, spirit, I need the spirit, I want to see fairies, like, I really believe in them, so I think they should be there, right? So I met this group of people at a hostel, and there was this one girl, and she had been backpacking all along the coast of Ireland. Her name was Dunya. Dunya in Doolin. Awesome, right? So after we were at this pub, she basically said to me, she's like, "It's a full moon. We must go and sing to her, the goddess." I don't really know what that accent is. I can't do a Swiss accent, so that's just what we got. "And you must go." Okay, so we go out to the woods and we're, you know, banging on pots and pans and singing to the goddess, you know? And then all of a sudden, out of the woods, out of the darkness, emerges these creatures, and I'm a city girl, so I'm scared of what is coming for us. And it turns out to be cows, and I'm like, I'm still scared of cows. Are they going to eat us? Trample us? What? She said, she started, like, banging the pot and going, "Gah! Gah! Gah!" like, to scare them away, and she's like, "You have to show them that you are not afraid. And that you belong in the field as much as they do." I don't know, I think she might be kind of Jamaican right now. So I'm gonna dedicate this song and bring up someone who has showed me that I belong in the field, and that is the legend Joey Arias. Thank you.
A streetlight on the corner of my redemption. The last midnight, ladies and
gentlemen.
Well, I'm lost and I end up. I know I have your love.
You know it, girl.
I'm right in this room.
Help me, girl.
Where the witness can the soul. Getting in the mood. It's night, cause she's good. Doesn't need anybody. Ooh, she pushes.
To the airport on my train.
it already happened, just follow your script. There's a lot in the
little when you put God in the What do they know? Standing on the other side of these broken green windows, heavy hands keep throwing stones.
Saves lives as well, and we're actually working together in April through Carnegie Hall, working with kids in detention centers and using music to heal. And so let's play this last video of the beautiful strangers that I met, because it is about us bringing this out to the world.
Peace, love, unity, and respect.
I thought that we missed an acronym.
Love, unity, and respect.
Adventure, go out there, you know, explore the world, you know what I mean? Go see the many cultures that are out there, you know, get to know people, you know?
To be back, to experience true, genuine love.
To let the people know what is happening in Mexico, because the lack of government.
Every single day.
It's
by the hands of the police, by the hands of the government.
We're looking for justice, democracy, and liberty.
Fighting to try to stay alive,
yes.
To grow, and to do something good for your country. But it's for this country that passes here and embraces the
What can you say, like, okay, this is the world's broken peace, this is how we need to grow?
Everyone as a whole needs to reflect on the past and our history and see what we've done, all of you. To start healing those plagues that we see that we have, you know, start literally completing humanity, like fill in those blanks that we're all missing.
Oh, that sounds so great.
Glasses.
Dear stranger, I love you too.
Yeah, the stranger in the morning.
Thank you.
sex on Facebook. Because someone stole my website and I was like, someone was selling. Oh, what? Oh, I lost it. Sorry. Thanks. He's correcting me. And he was selling football jerseys, and he's also a tech whiz, so he was helping me out. You guys jam for a second, all right? Just do, get your feel on. Get your feel on. Get your feel on.
Thank you.
outside.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to open it for you over there. Yeah?
Thank you.
Okay. What is it? Three? I'm not seeing it.